The Bentley Continental GT is the archetypal British Grand Tourer, a byword for sporting luxury with more pampering creature comforts than you'll find in any Aston Martin or Porsche, but mixed with the sporting performance and polish that are lacking in premium wannabes from Audi, BMW or Mercedes-Benz. It's a modern twist on a classical recipe, and after all, the name suggests it could cross whole continents in a day. But when's the last time you popped to Nice for dinner? Is there still a place in the modern world for this romantic notion of grand touring? To find out, we managed to persuade Bentley to let us borrow this car for nearly half a year. So watch on to find out how we got on over several thousand miles of playing a Bentley boy. We're now into the third generation of Continental GT, and it's matured into a very polished coupe and convertible. You won't mistake this for anything but a Bentley, with those huge quadruple headlights and a massive grille stretching nearly a metre wide. But our example has the black line specification, so all chrome and bright work is dulled out for a sinister, slightly footballer vibe, especially when juxtaposed with this St. James red paintwork. Huge 21-inch wheels fill the wheel arches, and just look at those enormous brake discs in here. Forget dinner plates, these are the size of dustbin lids. It's a 2+2, so there are only two doors, and they have soft close functionality, shutting the last few inches themselves, so you never have to do anything as uncouth as slamming a door. Now the best bit about the Conti is just how practical it is. This boot is 358 litres, and a really sensible, useful shape. It's even got a ski hatch so you can carry long loads, and we've easily packed in luggage for a family of four for a weekend away, even if we couldn't drive down to Nice during lockdown. Step inside and you really wouldn't know that this car shared some of its platform with the Porsche Panamera. It feels special, and this leather trim is so unlike what you'll find in a German competition. It's thick and luxurious and feels very expensive. You've got niceties such as the Bentley organ stop air vent controls, and there's this very James Bondy rotating display that flicks between analog dials or digital touchscreen depending on whether you're feeling trad or techno. There are more electronics and gadgets than you can shake a stick at. There's infrared night vision for spotting animals on the road at nighttime. Massaging seats with a choice of five different programs, and luxuries like heated armrests and air-conditioned seats. It's all slightly overkill if we're being honest, and it might explain why this car weighs in at a hefty 2.2 tons. All that mass becomes a little bit irrelevant once you set off, so we're testing the V8 Continental GT, not the top dog W12, and really we're not sure why you'd trade up. You've got 4 litres of twin turbocharged power. It's that engine you may be familiar with from the Porsche and Audi hotshot cars. And when it's developing 542 brake horsepower and 568 pound-foot, all the way from 2 to 4,500 RPM, well, you can imagine that performance is pretty ferocious. It does 0 to 60 in 3.9 seconds. Top speed, 198 miles per hour. And that's the entry-level Conti GT.
It's supercar fast, and this sporting ability defines the Bentley's character. We're simply not sure we'd pick the W12, which adds more weight and only a little extra performance, but a lot more cost. And we would find it hard to countenance something even thirstier than the 22 miles per gallon we've been managing this summer. Drive like a saint, and you'll just about squeeze out 30 miles from every gallon. But where the Bentley Continental GT really scores is in its amazing duality of purpose. Remember its grand touring credentials. It's the Jekyll and Hyde ability to outrace a Porsche 911 Carrera away from the traffic lights one moment, and then slip into comfort mode on the adaptive dampers the next. This is what the Continental does best. Few cars can match its extraordinary stretch of ability, and the range of its spectrum is indeed unique. Ride comfort is impressive. Refinement is whisper quiet thanks to double glazing and soundproofing aplenty, while those expensive massaging front seats are just mega. Although the driving position is quite high up if you're used to driving a rival Aston Martin or Porsche.
Now the Continental GT faces much more competition than it did back in 2003 when it arguably invented the whole sector. You've got the likes of Aston Martin reaching down. BMW and Mercedes, they want in on the action too. There's more choice for buyers. But you know what? We reckon the Conti is still probably the definitive GT for us. The way it juggles the old-fashioned notion of a long-distance cruiser, and yet also, at a flick of a switch, it can become a sports car. Not a Porsche, it's too heavy for that, but a very impressive sports car. It's just utterly intoxicating. There's probably going to be electrified versions on the way soon. We know a plug-in is under development, and hey, they could even get the Taycan technology in here one day. But right now, right here, I think the V8's the car to go for. I wouldn't bother with a W12. I think this is a great modern Bentley.